Hello, and welcome back to Bishop Carroll TV. I'm Claire Gunner.
And I'm Jacob Carlo. Oh, hey, Claire. Got a date for homecoming?
Sorry, Jacob. I already have a date. With the recent restructuring of the community system at Carroll, we took to the streets to see how the Wichita community views Carroll.
Connor Reason and Patrick Cook have the story.
We're here today at the Foundation of Human Civilization, Town West Square, and today, Connor and I are going to be asking people their impressions of Bishop Carroll. Let's say we get to it, huh?
That's right, Patrick.
So, sir, what do you think about Bishop Carroll?
Well, I've heard they've got a pretty good football program, but I think they might pay the refs.
Very reasonable.
Sir, what do you think about Bishop Carroll?
I think he was a nice guy, very underappreciated, but I really like his solo work. But when he was with his band, that he was probably not his strongest songwriting, but his solo work is really well.
Thanks. I was talking about the school, but great insight.
So, Hannah, what is your opinion of Bishop Carroll?
I think it seems like a pretty good school based on the merit and money.
Thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am. What do you think about Bishop Carroll?
Bishop Mark K. Carroll of the Roman Catholic Diocese of Wichita installed two Catholic boys' high schools, Bishop Carroll being the second. At first, he named the new school Notre Dame High School, but then Disney got mad and sued him.
Thanks, Connor and Patrick.
This broadcast, we caught up with the local Wichita boxer and Olympic bronze medalist, Nico Hernandez.
Here's Jake with the story.
All right, Mr. Hernandez, thank you very much for being here. I appreciate you taking time out of your day, so let's just jump right into it. First question, what do you believe are key factors of your training that directly contribute to your success?
Just a lot of hard work. And times I feel like giving up. You got to keep pushing yourself. A lot of early mornings, late nights, waking up in the morning, training, and going for runs, and just hard work and dedication.
Yeah, it's always the hardest part is sticking with it and stuff like that. Yeah, gotcha. And next question, what is the best piece of advice that you have ever been given since your boxing career started?
Just never give up.
Never give up.
Yeah, never tell yourself you can't do something, because if you put that in your head, you're not going to be able to do it. If you put it in your head that, hey, I can do that, that's easy, I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, of course.
You're gonna do it, but
of course.
Yeah, just don't give up and keep that mentality, that positive mentality.
Yeah, baby steps. That's all it's about. Baby steps. All right, and then next question: who inspires you to get into this ring every single day?
My family. My family inspires me because growing up I didn't have a lot, and I grew up around here.
Yeah.
In a more poor neighborhood. And, I want better for my future family and my parents. I want them to where I can take care of them so they don't got to work another day in their life.
Yeah.
My family is who inspires me.
Yeah, that's real strong inspiration. That's really good that you believe that.
Yeah.
And final question, what can not only the fans but the people of Wichita, Kansas look forward to on your fight?
Be ready to look forward to a great fight. I know my competition, and I've seen him fight, he's pretty good.
Yeah.
So I'm up there too. So
yeah.
And see what happens that night. It's all gonna come down to whoever trained the hardest, I believe. But just be ready for an action-packed fight, and I'm ready to hear the loud audience.
Gotcha. Understood. Well, you heard it first here, folks. Mr. Hernandez, don't miss his fight, September 23rd. I know I will be watching, and I know that many of you will too. Thank you very much, Mr. Hernandez.
Thank you.
Back to you.
Thanks, Jake. Hey, Jacob, do you think he could take on Nico?
Nope.
That's what I figured. As we progress through the school year, we continue our mission of exploring the inner workings of Bishop Carroll activities.
Today, our very own Alex Owens and Trevor Taylor are showing you what it's like to be in Bishop Carroll Drumline.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Day in the Life of BC Drumline. I'm Trevor.
And I'm Alex.
And today, we're here with Alex Hagerot and Josh Hittner, and today, they'll be showing us how to become a drummer on the BC Drumline. First, we'll start out with the bass drum.
All right, so we're going to be teaching you Down with the Sickness today, which is a song by Disturbed that we used to march the football team into the stadium. You're going to be doing the bass part. So you're going to start that off, and what it's going to go like is...
quads.
So Josh here is going to teach me how to play Down With The Sickness on the quads.
Right, so you start off with the two bottom drums, just repeat it three times, and then go to the first drum there.
You guys tried your best, but this is the way it's really done.
Wow, good job guys, but I'd leave the cadences to drumline.
I couldn't agree more. Now to Curtis Light with sports.
Ow! Cross country had a meet last Saturday at Cessna Activity Center. Guys took first while the girls took second. Wayne Hesse and Claire Winter both took first in their races. Soccer is 7-1-1 and finished second place at the Titan Classic. Girls golf took first at the Clap Golf Course and took second last Tuesday at Sim Park Golf Course. Tennis is 6-0 in the City League. Volleyball record is 5-1 in the City League. Next Tuesday, they have a triangular here at Bishop Carroll. Football is still perfect with a 4-0 record so far. The next game is next week at Derby. The theme is Christmas in September, so bring your ugly sweaters. That's it for sports. Back to you guys.
Good luck to our fall sports teams as they continue through the season.
Last Friday was Military Appreciation Day. To show our appreciation, we talked with a former Carroll student who has joined the military.
I'm here today with John Newman, Bishop Carroll graduate of 2017, on Military Appreciation Night. So John, why'd you decide to enlist?
Well, I thought it was a good choice. Help serve this country. Best.
What advice do you have for kids looking to enlist?
The advice I would give would be don't give up, stick with your decision, and be glad you chose it.
We thank all of our military personnel for their service.
Hey Jacob, can you show me your favorite dance move?
No, Claire, I can't. But let's check in the lunchroom, see if anybody else can.
Can you show us your favorite dance move? How many books are in the New Testament?
7.
Not quite. Tam, if you could sing one song in American Idol, what would it be?
One song, you say?
Yes.
What is it? What's Up by the Four Blondes.
I don't know that song, Tam.
It's the one that goes like, what is it? Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah.
Next American Idol winner right here. Chloe, can you name all 8 communities?
Yes, of course. There's a JP2, Max Colby, Andre Bessette, St. Teresa of Lisieux, Mother Teresa, Dominic Savio, Philip Neri.
One more.
St. Sebastian.
Let's give her a round of applause. If pro is the opposite of con, what is the opposite of progress?
Congress.
You heard it here.
Thanks, Cam.
Now here to deliver the morning announcements is the Blake Freeman.
We're having shrimp poppers for lunch.
Today is a green extended schedule. Dental screenings are all day, so we're doing that. Final trash bag collection is today, so get those in. Psychology meeting Monday after school in room 602. And October 4th is open mic night, so get your lyrics too. Miss Johnson. Powderpuff halftime dancers are still needed. Also, signed waiver in so students can use the inflatables at the Golden Eagle Jamboree. That's all for our announcements. I'll play you out.